If right now you are using Google Drive File Stream or Backup and Sync, there are some important changes happening that have been announced in 2021. I'm going to take you through what those changes are and why you need to take action if you're currently using Google Backup and Sync, and where you go with all that data stored and synchronized on your desktop to make sure that it's safely secured in the cloud. My name's Pete Moriarty, and I founded a company called IT Genius, and we help business owners all over the world with their technology needs. Now, whether you are a small business owner just getting started out, or if you're growing and scaling up your business, then we are here to help. And we take businesses through the growth roadmap of the different technology strategies that are suitable for businesses at different sizes. If you're interested in learning more about that, you can check out our playlists on our YouTube channel on the link below, and our team will show you how you can learn, no matter what stage of business you're at, to get more out of your tech. Now, in this video, I'm covering what are the changes in the Google Drive Sync solution world and why you need to take action if you're still using Backup and Sync. Now, if you don't already know what's kind of happening in the Google world, well, a couple of years ago, Google created from one Google Drive app multiple Google Drive apps for desktop. And it got a little bit confusing, but they eventually kind of clarified that one was best suited for personal use and another was best suited for business use. Now, the Google Backup and Sync was basically useful for synchronizing in the old way that Google used to work. So a little bit like Dropbox, you would be able to choose folders and have them synchronized right down to your desktop. It also had some other cool features like being able to synchronize your Google Photos. And what that meant was you could back up photos stored in folders on your computer automatically into Google Photos. Now, Google File Stream came along and it changed one important thing. And that was that with Google File Stream, you could see every folder online, but you didn't have to download the contents of every single folder down to your desktop to access them. And so File Stream was more useful for business users who maybe had a lot of data sitting in Google Drive, but you still wanted to access it from the local desktop. So if you were working on a Microsoft Word document and hit the save button, you could save it straight into your Google Drive without having to save it to the desktop and kind of like upload it to the web, or without having to juggle which folders you synchronize and which folders you don't synchronize by using the selective sync folder in the Backup and Sync app. Now, Google has said that they have decided to bring both of those technology tools together now. And what that means is they are going to be discontinuing the Backup and Sync tool and just moving to a new consolidated tool called Drive for Desktop. Now, you'll still have the ability and the option to connect to all of your files in your Google Drive online. You'll still have the ability to connect to shared folders online. And so if you're using a business workspace account and in there you've got shared folders, which is the best way to share for businesses, you'll be able to access those too. But Google will also allow you to synchronize whole folders and keep them available offline using the offline files feature. The ability to automatically synchronize your documents and your photos in your local desktop automatically into Google Photos online. But they have some other solutions for synchronizing Google Photos. Now, what does this mean for you if you're a business IT leader and you need to roll this out for your team members? Well, if they're already using Google File Stream, that's fine. That's going to automatically transition to the new Drive for Desktop, and so there's no reinstallation or changes that you need to make happen. But if right now you're using Google Backup and Sync, eventually you'll start receiving messages that that's going to be discontinued, and there's a new version called Drive for Desktop that you will need to actually download. Now, it's pretty straightforward. You download it, you sign in, you install your username and password. From there, it's going to start synchronizing and connecting to your computer. And just remembering, if you want to access any of those files offline, to right-click on a folder, click Available Offline, and then you'll be able to get access to them. Now, if you're interested in any support with migrating with Google Drive, if you've still got files in folders on your desktop, or maybe you've still got stuff hanging around in a Dropbox somewhere and you want to migrate them into the latest Google Drive with all of the amazing features that are available, get in touch with our team. Jump on a consultation on the link below and see if our team are a good fit to work with you. No matter where you are in the world, we have solutions for business owners of all sizes. And if you're not already working with us, but you are using Google Workspace, well, you might be interested in taking advantage of our free transfer in offer. Now, when you transfer your billing into IT Genius, you don't pay any extra, but you get a bunch of amazing support from our team. Now, not only do you get basic support for free from our professional services team, you also get access to our Genius Academy, which is a classroom of professional videos helping you and your team get the most out of Google Workspace. Now, we want to take you from wherever you are now to Genius level on your Google Workspace, including your staff as well, so that everyone on your team can be more productive. And to do that, we take you you through our classes in Google Classroom, and we even have quizzes and certifications to make sure that your team are up to speed. Now, we imagine this is the best way for you to have your team automatically onboarded into the Google ecosystem when they first start working for you. But all of your existing team could probably retroactively learn a few things in the Google ecosystem and getting the most out of the platform, and so we highly recommend putting them through that training. Not only that, but just having your billing through us means that if there's ever an emergency with your account, if you're hacked or you're locked out or you have something go wrong, we are just one phone call away. So if you're interested in that offer, jump on the link below, and I look forward to seeing you on the other side. Cheers.